Welcome to the third of four short videos that shows raters and HVAC installers how to measure the airflow of whole house ventilation systems. In this video, James and I will be showing you how to measure the airflow at the outlet terminal. The outlet terminal is where the ventilation air exits the ventilation system. And one common example of this is a wall termination for an exhaust fan. We'll be using James's mock-up again, but this time we'll be measuring the airflow as it exits the ventilation system, over there. At this location, there are two ways to measure the airflow, using a powered flow hood or a bag inflation device. In the second video, we showed you how to use a powered flow hood at the inlet terminal. The exact same equipment and procedure can be used at the outlet terminal, so we won't duplicate it here. Though we did test it off camera and got an airflow measurement of 60 CFM. That means we just have one new device to show you in this video, the bag inflation device. Now, despite the fact that this is less sophisticated than some other devices, it's actually been demonstrated to be one of the more accurate ones available. That's why ResNet standards allow this device to be used here. To measure the airflow, you'll just need it and a stopwatch. To start, James will make sure that the bag is completely emptied of air and that the shutter is closed. Now he and I will work together. On the count of three, James will remove the shutter and I'll start the stopwatch.
One, two, three.
Okay, I stopped the watch when the bag was fully inflated, 8.3 seconds. Because we know the volume of the bag plus the box is 55 gallons and the elapsed time was 8.3 seconds, we can calculate the airflow in CFM, which gives us 53 CFM. This is a pretty straightforward and accurate way to measure the airflow at the outlet terminal. So there you have it, two ways to measure the ventilation airflow at the outlet terminal. ResNet's new standard allows either of these devices to be used by raters at this location, and we got pretty similar results. Now move on to the fourth and final video to see how to measure airflow midstream in the ventilation duct.